She's having trouble getting comfortable, guys. She hasn't really eaten very good for the last 2 days. She holds her tail down. She wakes up and screams, yelps. So we're on our way to take Jacob to school. We, as in me and Jacob. And after I drop him off, I'm taking Precious to the vet. Like you saw a couple seconds ago.
The mosquitoes be hungry.
You just do this, dude. That's all you gotta do is just wave your hand a little bit. I'm taking Precious up to the vet. See what they're gonna say about her. Or me and Amy are worried because she's in a lot of pain. Like she'll lay there, like I showed you, she'll just lay there, but then all of a sudden, like about every 20 minutes or so, she just pounces up and yelps and takes off running all frantically and won't stop. And then when she sits down again, it takes her forever to get comfortable. She's keeping her tail down. So, I mean, that's an obvious sign of something's wrong when they just hold their tail down the whole time.
Why are you worried?
Well, we're worried because it could be something that's really wrong with her and she could be really sick and there might not be a way to fix her. Remember how the Shaytards had Malachi? Remember their big dog? And he got real sick.
And he died?
Yeah, and they had to take him to the vet and he died.
That might happen to Precious.
It might happen to Precious. So you might not get to see her again. And she was Amy's first kid, basically, because she got her and that was our little daughter we had. And that was before we were even thinking about having kids. So it kind of helped us get in the mode of knowing that we were responsible for something besides ourselves. And now it's just it was a long night. Amy's been up since like 4:30 because she's been yelping and can't get comfortable.
I hope she'll not die.
Yeah, we all hope that.
Because I love Precious very much. She's the sweetest dog in the world.
Okay, baby. So we're here at the vet now. Okay, baby. So they took her back to Lair and she yelped back there. He picked her up. Yeah. So he's the vet tech that has seen her several actual vet will be in a few minutes. Hope we find out what's going on with Miss Precious here. All right, so it is 1:30 in the afternoon. Update number 2 on Miss Precious. We're on our way to go pick her up. Amy decided to ride too so that she can hear exactly how to do the medicine and everything. So what we know is that her back is in pretty bad shape. She's got like what's the stuff called that's around your vertebrae? Yes. The squishy part around your disc? Around your discs?
Around your vertebrae is the disc.
Yeah. Do what?
The disc is in between the vertebrae.
So is it
degenerative
disc
is what she has.
Okay. Well, anyways, one of her discs has like no squishiness in between it or anything, so it's causing her a lot of pain pretty often. And the rest of like from her like mid back all the way down to her pelvic area, the spine is like got a lot of arthritis built up on it, so it's causing lots of pain. And the doctor put her on some pain medicine right now, so that she's doing better with the pain medicine. So we're gonna have to have her on pain medicine for a little while. It's better than having to have surgery, so I'm happy about that. It's just going to require us to keep an eye on her a lot more and not let her jump up and down off of things. Like, she can't do cartwheels anymore. She can't run the Greyhound races anymore.
She was so good at that, too.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's a happy thing because we know that we're not having to do what we were thinking we were going to have to do at this point. But it's also
suffering still.
Well, yeah, see, that's the only downside. She's suffering if we don't keep her on pain medicine. If we keep her with the pain medicine, she's okay. At least that's what the doctor says. She says she wants us to try it out with her for a little while. So that's the route we're going to go. We're gonna hope that she starts getting better with just having the pain medicine and resting and not. And we'll open up the door for her, not make her go out the doggy door and stuff like that. I don't know. We'll see. What are we doing?
Feeding birds.
What are we doing?
I'm a duck.
Are they already on their way up here? Look, they already came up here. Let's go over to the shade. Make them follow us. Yeah, don't. He's like, yeah, give it to me. He ain't shy.
Hey, do you want them?
What's up, dude?
Do you want the big one?
What's going on? Man, they're fussing over here. They're telling you guys to feed them. Look at this one over here walking up by himself. He's trying to sneak up on them. Hey, are you swinging in my swing? Huh? Yeah. And Mommy and Bubba are playing catch. Show me how good you can throw it, Jacob. Man, look at that.
I'm very happy that Precious is still with us. And I just love her so much. I don't want her die, and let's go find Precious. Hey, Precious girl, what are you doing? Precious, are you still alive? Daisy, you want outside? Oh, Daisy.
I just realized that Amy went shopping, guys, and didn't tell me. Look at this.
And all his winter clothes that Xander has.
What are you doing going shopping, honey?
I'm not. I'm shopping in our attic.
Oh. They left these in the attic? The last people that lived here?
No, these are all Jacob's.
Holy moly. He's got a lot of pants.
And shirts. And he's still in pajamas.
And you still have another load in the wash,
still
right?
Another load in the dryer. So he is set for winter.
Xander, you have lots of neat clothes now? Huh?
No, these are mine.
I know. Do you have lots of neat clothes? You like them?
These are your favorite pajamas, huh? Wonder Pets.
Wonder Pets. Yeah? Show us your other cool jacket you got. Your hands are in the way now. Is that Batman and Robin? What? That's awesome.
Thank you, Bubba.
Say, yeah. Clothes. Yeah, for getting so big and growing. Thanks a lot.
And giving them your hand-me-downs.
So how was your day today, honey? Start from the top. How'd your day go?
Well, Precious woke me up at like 4:30 because she was yelping. And she had yelped once the night before and woke us both up, and it scared us. We're like, what was that, you know? Because she never does that. So then she did again last night, you know, at 4:30 in the morning. I walked around the house. I couldn't find her. She ended up being in the backyard. And I guess she yelped when she jumped through the doggy door. So then I found her outside, and I was trying to get her to come in, and she wouldn't. And then I heard her yelp coming back through the doggy door. And I don't know, it happened probably 5 more times. And one of the times it woke up Eric, and he's like, what's wrong? I'm like, I don't know, you know. I can't get her to calm down. You know, she was panting, she was hurting, couldn't get comfortable. So then he took her to the vet for me. And then that's when they did the x-rays and blood work. And $380 later, she's home.
But we still don't have a firm, this is exactly what's going to fix everything, because nothing's going to fix anything.
She's still in pain. She's already yelped a couple times since she's been home. So yeah, we're hoping this works, but it sounds like she's going to be on pain meds for the rest of her life. So we'll see. What are you doing? Where are you taking my clean towels on the dirty floor? You're so funny.
It was like comfortable.
Ah. That's where you guys are sleeping tonight.
Okay. It's bedtime, so everybody good night.
Night.
Come on.
I cannot keep up.
Let's tell everybody good night.